Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Kamil, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts from all evil doubts and desires. Our next speaker, bi'idhnillah, will be Sheikh Ala Sayyid. Sheikh Ala Sayyid is the Director of Religious Affairs for ISNA, and he's also the Director of Public Relations for Mission Mercy. And Sheikh Ala Sayyid, inshallah, will be talking about how pornography affects marriage. فليتفضل الشيخ علاء.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله بعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته, my dear Prince Islam, and welcome to another episode of Gloves Off, inshallah. And we'll talk about it, and indeed we will talk about certain things that may feel awkward for some of you, and some of you will think that we'll have to stick our head in the sand, and unfortunately you're going to be a little bit surprised today. So I'm apologizing in advance for a few things that may offend some of you, but it's somebody has to do it. So please let us go on this lovely roller coaster ride of talking about pornography and how it really does affect your marriage. So I'll be sharing some stories with you. I'll be sharing some statistics with you. I'll also talk about some of the things that I think personally that would work. Again, there's no scientific facts behind it, but it's something that I've been doing for over 30 years. I'm talking about some couples that came to my office, of course, without divulging any of the secrets or the names, but I'm just talking about really does happen, how it does. So let us, inshallah, put our seatbelts on and come with me on this lovely journey of how the truth about the pornography industry and what it does to your marriage. So please note that some of this stuff will be a little bit surprising to some of you. Some of you can relate to it. So I'm going to talk about before marriage, during marriage, and after marriage. And hopefully some of you will be looking into preventative measures. Some of you will be reactive measures, and some of you will have to be looking forward to some of the speeches later on for Sheikh Habib Tuwail to how to come back on the effects. So I'm going to stick to my topic, but in the end, I'll give you some hopefully solutions and certain things that would help you, practical, realistic solutions. And as I said, again, gloves are off. So here we go. So some of the examples that some of us can relate to. I want you to imagine, brothers and sisters, that you're playing a game. And mashallah, you're the best at this game. And you're reaching over 1,000 level, and you're a pro now. You know, you're the man. And you know, you've been playing this basketball game or whatever it is, game that you're online, and you're excelling in it, and all of a sudden you're the expert now. But now your name is called up to actually perform live in court. Lights are on, people are watching, and all of a sudden you choke. Literally choke. And that's exactly what happens, my brother and sister, that most of us do. When we watch pornography at the average age of 12 onwards, we get used to this. We're comfortable. We're the experts. One side, behind the shield. You're just looking at certain things as you're playing a game. And all of a sudden, you get married, and you're the one who's performing, not the one you're watching, and not the one that you're doing certain things and whatever. You are the one who is actually performing. The lights, the spotlights are on you. You're now, you are the actor, you're the one that the hero, you're the one that from a hero to zero all of a sudden. And that's exactly what happens, my brothers and sisters. For so long, you've been watching a game, you've been doing this, you're playing online, and all of a sudden, you have to perform. And it's you to you. And all of a sudden, you get shocked, you choke, and all of a sudden, you're on the other line, and all of a sudden, these things are totally different. Wallahi, I remember the first time I got on the pulpit, I turned around, and I was watching everybody watching me give a khutbah. And I was like, oh my God, it's totally different than you watching Imam giving a khutbah. It's exactly the same. Well, you understand, not exactly the same, but you know what I mean for that. So I want you to let you know that pornography in this porn industry is a multi-million dollar, a billion dollar industry. And it has to grab your attention visually so quickly, otherwise you lose interest. It's that competitive. So they hire professional actors in order for them to do this job. And you think you can compare yourself to that, you'll be surprised. Spoiler alert. You will understand that these are entertainment performed by actors, and they give you that show in a nutshell. And it absolutely has nothing to do with reality. I want you to think that your life, your family life, and compare it to a 30-minute sitcom. It is not the same. And I assure you, they're not the same. So you cannot tell me in a 30-minute sitcom, they're going to tell me the truth about life, the difficulties I'm going through with my children and with my spouse, and the financial aspect, social aspect, religious aspect, the stress, the pressure, the job, everything. It's impossible. It's exactly the same. So So if you're, there's a porn is no more real than this 30 minutes episode of sitcom to our lives and sexual life and intimacy life. It's just built upon a pure lie. So keep that in mind when we're talking about this. So I'm going to share some stories with you. And these are true stories without obviously divulging the sources and the names. Wallahi alladhi la ilaha illahu. I have dealt with so many couples that complain about sexual lack of intimacy, lack of sexuality in their lives. They're losing it. And I'm talking about this when I'm talking about, you know, keeping in mind that 89% of men, brothers and sisters, statistics show that 89% of men get married just for sexual intercourse. Could you imagine? That's very high. So noting that among the secrets that men are physically based, women are emotionally based, you have to keep that in mind. And don't belittle it, my dear sisters out there. It means a lot to us. It's number one. You understand? It's number one on our list. So please, keep, you know, you're going to do tajarrud. You're going to listen now with our hearts, mind, and soul. Keep it in mind, a balanced approach to it. Speaking of balance, please make sure you understand that this is not a problem with the brothers only, wallahi. Sisters also get addicted, but obviously the ratio is a little less. But the statistics show that both brothers and sisters get addicted. And I'm not talking about brothers and humanity. I'm talking about our own brothers and sisters. You understand that the high ratio is in Muslim countries and so on, but it has nothing to do with that. It has nothing to do with our own. So when you're talking about some of the stories I'm going to share with you today, that some of the couples got divorced because of that reason. And this is something personal that I had to go through. I am dealing with the couple, and the brothers obviously been watching porn for a long time. And when you got married, you know, all of a sudden, things are different. You know why? Because you're used to certain things that are you cannot compare. And I'm going to go through the stories and the 10 points. I'm going to share 10 points with you how pornography affects your marriage, literally how it affects your marriage, you personally also. So the brother was expecting certain things that it was not there. So he was telling the sister to do certain things, and the sister was getting offended. And of course, you understand that this is touched up, you know, photoshopped and screened and cut and redone, and using some whatever blue pills and whatever you want to call it. They're not real. They're not real. So the sister thinks that, you know what, if the brother sees her, Allahu Akbar, that's all he needs. We live in a very hyper-sexually organized and it's society that we're living in right now. Everything is done so. So I'm going to give you some advice in the end, inshallah. By the time we finish this, hopefully you'll have a tool in your hand. So notice that these are true stories. Wallahi, I just received a phone call. I'm going to share with you a little bit more about the infidelity. The sister had four different brothers, and they were married, man. I'm talking about, you know, where that takes you, where it hasn't. This is just recent. And the amount of people I have within my office complaining about the porn in their life, in their marriage, what an effect it has it on, these are true stories. Of course, they ended up being divorced, unfortunately. And you'll see the rate, you'll be shocked what the rate is about. So keep that in mind, and inshallah, we'll go on to the thing. So, you know what, we get questions. You know, we've heard what kind of questions people usually ask. You know, is it true that all men look at porn, for example? Is it unrealistic not to have or not to want porn in your marriage? Does porn-free marriage exist? Why does it matter if a husband looks at porn anyway, right? They think it's norm. And I'm going to talk about what the society tells us and what is science tells us statistically. And now says, what does it really matter anyway? And if he's, you know, if he's going to look at porn, why don't you just join him so he doesn't feel bad about it and so on? And there's so many things that we can share with you, inshallah. And how do I deal with a spouse that has that addiction? But I'm going to, again, you know, understanding that I'm going to leave some of the stuff to the other mashaykh. May Allah bless them, inshallah. So is porn good for your sex life? These are the questions actually that are done. And obviously, here's what the society says, and I will go into the scientific accent, what it says. So this is what the society usually tells you. You know what? All men look at porn. And then they actually will tell you, if a man is telling you, I'm not looking at porn, he's lying. It's that induced into the genes in our society. That's norm. This is the norm now. You get desensitized doing this stuff. So it says men can't help themselves. That's how they're built. So they justify it with the rationale, justification. So looking for porn is normal and okay nowadays. And that's what obviously it's not. And if he's looking at porn again, he's lying to you. If he says he's not looking at porn, and you should have this porn to induce some kind of spark in your relationship. It says women feel it doesn't matter anyway. Their husband looking at it doesn't matter, as long as, you know what, he still has me and it's not infidelity, but that's what it leads to, unfortunately, some of the cases. At least nothing is not cheating on you. And that's basically what they justified. Some of the sisters will say, you know what, at least he's not cheating on you. Subhanallah. And if sex is not, the man is not looking for that, he will look. And if you don't sext him, you know, you don't have this lovely sexual relationship with your husband, he will cheat on you, or he will look at pornography. And you know what, just if you can't beat him, join him mentality. And if join him so he doesn't feel guilty about it. And again, porn is harmless anyway. Isn't that amazing? Subhanallah, ajeeb wallahi. Now, let's talk about what science says, not what the society says. It says, you know what, there are 10 things I'm going to talk about, how pornography affects and damages your marriage. But the truth is, pornography is not strengthening, it's weakening it. And they will tell you that. They will tell you, you know what, there's strengthening, it adds a spark into it. If you really want to love each other so much more, it doesn't. That has more harm than benefit, and it weakens, not strengthen your marriage. That's a fact. In all legitimate research studies we found no benefits for pornography, only damage. And this is for over 30 years. 56% of the divorce cases involve party of that obsessive internet pornography. That is over 500,000 a year of divorce cases just because of pornography. I mean, amazing, wallahi. So let's talk about the 10 quickly, inshallah. Number one, porn breaks the trust in your marriage. Why? Because it's a secret. So if you get caught, what happens? The trust is gone. Because whether you like it or not, this is something that it's intimate between couples. So if you're not going to do that, you're going to lose the trust. And it's a challenge. I'm going to give you a challenge, brothers. Okay, you're the man. You think you're the man, right? In front of the brothers, you say, I'm the man. I'm a lion here, but at home, you go, meow, right? Okay, I'm going to give you a challenge, brothers, especially the brothers. I want you, when you go home tonight, give your cell phone that some of you are watching me right now through. Give your cell phone to your wife. You know where I'm going with that, right? And here's what we do. Some of the brothers are actually, when they give their phone to their wives, they say the beginning of Surah Yasin. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ سَدًّا وَالْخَطِيهِمْ سَدًّا فَأَخْشَيْنَاهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُبْصُرُونَ حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. So, or you change your PIN, or you have a dual SIM card, or you have a hidden file, another password, and all of that stuff. I'm challenging you to do that. If you're not, if you can do it, alhamdulillah. If you can't, then you know what? You better rethink this. May Allah help us all, wallahi. Okay, so number two is the porn hinders your emotional intimacy. The fact is, the pornography leads to objectification rather than meaningful interaction and with another person. And the reason for that is, brother, is the difference between having sex and making love. Huge difference. It's because, you know, making love is about a connection. But sex is about pleasure. And sex is about a body, but making love is about a person. Huge difference. So there's an oxytocin and testosterone is a hormones that actually men and women produce when they have intimate relations between making love between a husband and wife. And that's called the feel-good hormone. And if you have it on your own, you will lose that intimacy. It's not because you understand. It's a print in your memory. When you have a satisfaction or a desire, it will print it in your brain where and when and how it was done. And you will be addicted accordingly. So your childhood has a lot to do with what you're doing right now. And that's why I tell the brothers, listen, man, dude, if you're going to do this early on in your life, you're going to pay a price later on, whether you like it or not. Because it's not the same. You understand, I mean, as I said, gloves are off. The speed, the grip, the tightness, the velocity of it, the scene, the smell, everything, by the way, my brothers and sisters, has a place in your mind that will affect you. And if you don't get that satisfaction from your wife, it's going to be a huge impact on you. And obviously, if that's the case, then the hormones will not be done. If it's not with your wife, that intimate relations will be lost, of course. Number three on the list is porn destroys self-esteem. You know why? Because when you look at the porn stars, when you look at these guys, they're touched up and they're not real, by the way. I'm sure you know that by now. You start comparing that to your wife and you look at her, you know what? She's gained weight after the children. She's lost a bit of weight. She has a little bit of, you know, the gravity is looking after certain things now. Look at that. You know what? I see some certain lines. Things are different now. And then you start not feeling very attracted towards your wife and you still see toward that, you're losing it. Not only that, my brothers, you're not looking at your wife in that way, you're looking at yourself because you're not performing as well with your wife as the other brother from another mother. Now, do you think that, wow, is this for real? No, it's not. So please understand also that number three on the list, porn affects your self-esteem for you and your wife. May Allah protect us, Ya Rab. Ameen. Number four, porn causes selfishness. Why? Because you're born, when you're watching porn, you're basically trying to please yourself. So it's like, what have you done for me? It's not what I can do for you. So it's not give and take. It's just myself and I. Yeah? Me. Something like this. So all you're doing right now is basically looking for, what you're bringing sexual pleasure to myself, not to your wife. So please understand, my brothers, I'm going to give you an advice right now. Please make sure you look after your wife first before you look after yourself. You have a different graph. You understand it takes a long time for the woman to go up in the zone. And it plateaus for a long time. Then it takes a long time to come down. For us brothers, our peak is up and down. You understand? So don't tell me, you know what? I got mine, you get yours. It doesn't work that way. Please make sure you look after your wife before you look after yourself. There are different curves. So do your homework. Understand. Communicate. And I will talk about that a little bit later, inshallah, when I finish this this lecture. And I'll give you some of the suggestions that I have noticed that worked with some couples. And I've done a little bit of research. And hopefully that will help us all, inshallah. Number five on the list. The porn actually demeans women. By the way, statistics show that the more the men watch porn, they want now a submissive woman, one that surrenders, the one that's is a subordinate. Because they just tell her what to do. Yes, sir. Aye, sir. You know, it's the Sayyid syndrome. So please understand that kind of demeans the woman. It makes she becomes a sexual object. And alhamdulillah, Islam honors women three times higher than men as a mother and a father. Understand that the mission stick of us brothers and sisters, how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the best of you, the best is wife, and so on and so forth. If I talk about this, it's not a home sweet home lecture, you know, but let's talk about this. Please understand that. So note that this is one thing you're going to be looking at your wife, how the abusive part of it, how the part that we're not supposed to do, it will seep in, whether you like it or not, sooner or later. So may Allah protect us from that. Ameen. Number six. Porn impairs your sex life. Okay, they had a survey telling men before and after sex, like when they had porn addiction, and it shows that 19% suffer premature ejaculation, and 25% are disinterested in sex with their partners. 31% have difficulties reaching orgasm, and 34% experience erectile dysfunction. That's huge. Now, they also did another survey with men that did not were not exposed or they came off the addiction. So 60% of them, they says that the sexual function is improved after they've left it. And 67% of them, they said that they had more energy of doing this in their sexual life. So this was something that is extremely important to understand how the porn has effect on your marriage. So this is number seven on the list. This is now the porn leads to marital dissatisfaction. So in that case, the research found out that after men was exposed to pornography, the rate themselves, their love in the partnership, their men between men and women, it's been lost. So they don't want to have this. They don't see this love connection anymore. They didn't see anything to do other than the outside of the porn. That's all the addiction was. And here's the worst part. The more you watch porn as a fantasy, is that it makes you harder to have this loving relationship between you and your wife. And the longer it takes to get out of it. So it's extremely harmful to your marriage and your love relationship. Number eight on the list is that porn is a gateway to infidelity. Now, as I mentioned to you before, just last week, I've heard a sister had intimate relation with four different brothers, not their husband. Her husband travels a bit. So all of a sudden, she has intimacy with other men than other her husband, four in the same time. It's unbelievable. And I'm not talking about the, different men. This is a different time. I'm not talking about the fantasy, get your mind out of it. Well, it's in there anyway. So Allah help us. May Allah protect us all from that. So please understand that the research says increases 300%. 300. When you're watching porn, increases the chances of infidelity for 300%. That's amazing. Wallahi. I have dealt with so many couples of wallahi. Brothers and sisters, don't get me wrong. Brothers and sisters. A brother cheats on his wife. A sister cheats on her husband, and it's unbelievable. Wallahi, sometimes if you shake your head, may Allah protect us from that. But when you look at the root cause analysis, you'll find out it's pornography. So I'm telling you, the statistics show, and this is for over 30 years now, they've been doing these statistics. It has 300% increase in infidelity if you're addicted to porn. And because watching porn dismisses the relationship commitment, it's okay. Because you see others do it, you know what? Oh, yeah. You do this, I do that, and the swingers and all of that. Allah help us, wallahi. Please don't surf this. I don't want to give you something bad. I'm trying to get you off the hook. Okay. So it says, you know, the fantasy line with the cheating, it gets them a little bit of a jolt to something new and whatever it is, the revive. It's all horrible. Now, again, the porn-free relationship were stronger. A lot less infidelity. It's actually 50% more, less infidelity when it comes to any relationship that has no porn in it when it comes to that. I'm not saying this is the only thing that's going to happen. Obviously, some people have the principles of marriage and their own belief, as the Sheikh was talking about earlier, may Allah bless them, are weak, and that's where we have to rekindle it, come back all the time, inshallah. Number nine on the list, brothers, porn is linked to depression and stress and anxiety. Again, they say make sure that it's not the reason or the one that has to do with it, but indeed it has a lot to do with it, with you having being anxiety and stress and the pressure of you performing when you're watching, you're addicted to porn. And this is what the recovery of using the reports as a reduction of social anxiety is common improvement that stops with using the internet porn. So if you really want to stay off that, if you're relaxed, if you're only having one sister to perform with, and you're used to each other, you're talking about secrets, I'm going to end up with the positive, inshallah, to be able to give you some things that help end with it. Number nine, and the last one on the list here, is porn alters your brain. And this is the fact that it physically changes your brain. It physically changes your brain. And added, the really scary part is the more porn you look at, the more severe the damage to their brain becomes. It's more difficult to break free because the you're in the hole. And the number one golden rule in the hole is stop digging. But brothers, you're stopped. We're not stop digging. We're still digging. So the deeper you go in the hole, the most difficult for you to be able to do so. So again, to answer the earlier question, no, not all men look at porn. Yes, there are still some among the few. May Allah make us among the few. Whichever does have its way. Principles of honoring the vows that we take. The principles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watches us on. And I want you to just have a GoPro on your forehead. Okay, dude? Just, I'm going to give you some things to change in your bedroom. And again, I've been doing this for a while now, for over 30 years. When I go to teach these courses or talk around, whatever, it doesn't matter in the world. It's the same issues, different names and different faces. As a matter of fact, I used to get very upset with the brothers when I used to teach a course and they come up with some questions after the course is over. They tell me, Sheikh, they were talking about is oral sex allowed or not allowed? Can you use stories? Can you use all of this stuff? I used to get angry with them because if we don't give them the answers, where are they going to get it? And listen, man, do you think that they don't know about this stuff? It's a whole wide world now, dude. So let's get our head, don't stick in the sand, just get out of the sand and move on. Face the music and come on, you know, wake up and smell the hummus, man. Because wallahi, it's an issue, it's a pandemic. I'm not talking about the COVID-19 pandemic, I'm talking the addiction pandemic. Allah protects us from all the pandemics, man. So here's what usually happens. If the brothers and the sisters have to communicate with one another, okay? But before I go there, I want you, brothers, all the sisters, anyone that is addicted, I want you to think that you have a GoPro on your forehead. Cool? I want you to record everything, especially the things when you're all alone. You know when you close all the doors and the only door is open is your bedroom door? You know when everything else is like, you know, when you open the laptop and when you open your cell phone or whatever it is, and when you're all alone, everybody goes to sleep and goes... You know what I mean? You know what I mean? No, you don't know what I mean? Well, just me, I, Allahu Akbar. I'm talking to righteous people. They don't know what I'm talking about. That is amazing. The nur, the light. I have to get my sunglasses, man, because mashallah, yani, tabarakallah. That's amazing. Yani. Anyway, may Allah help us. So please note, Sheikh, if you have this GoPro on your forehead, I want you to record everything you see, everything you hear, everything you were with, every place you were in, every company you were with, and everything you've done, everything you heard, everything you said, everything you've seen. I want you to give me this GoPro. I want to download it. I want to show it in your messages, in your family. Worse yet, it's going to be on Judgment Day, dude. 99 files, every file as far as your eyesight can see. مالي هذا الكتاب لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها وجن وعمل حاضرة ولا يظلم ربك أحد. Everything you've done. So I'm going to give you some homework. Cool? from now on. You know that the two angels are watching you, dude. So what do you think? You think that they're going to, oh, nah, you know what, that's okay. But I'm going to tell you, I'm not going to close the door. Repentance is coming up and how to get addicted is coming up. So listen to Mashaykh. Yeah. So please note that I want you to, from now on, I want you to think that your eyes are camera lenses. I want you to think that your mouth and your ears are your MP3. Yeah. They're downloading everything you've seen, heard, and said. But you cannot hide this DVD, man, or the USB and whatever it is that you're using nowadays. You cannot hide that in your drawer. No, it will be uploaded on Judgment Day, Habibi. 50,000 years, everybody will be watching you. Can you imagine that, man? Allahu Akbar. Everybody thinks that you're a hero. Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah, yani. You're the man. And you're the, MashaAllah, in the masjid, in front of everybody, you act like Abu Bakr. At home, you act like Abu Jahl. You know what? I'm not closing. I said the repentance door is open. The repentance is open, shit. My shaykh are coming. I'm not going to go there. Because you know what? They're going to talk about it in details. Listen to them. Finally now. So as I said, gloves are off. You know, dude, listen, I know some of the madahib, they say, you know what, you're not allowed to watch the awrah, the private parts of your wife. And with all due respect to all the madahib, all the imams, may Allah bless them. They've done their best to give us this deen hour and whatever we can listen to, inshallah. However, please note that if you see awrah, if you see these women in humanity out there showing you, voluntarily showing you their bodies, and especially in the summer, may Allah help us all. And you go home to your wife, and you cannot see her private part, where do you go, dude? Come on. Listen, the hadith said, you know what? They used to wash in the same pot. Do you have the same clothes? So please, let's just be realistic here. And some of the people, you know, when they talk about oral sex, listen. So mafhum al-mukhalafa ya akhi. When I want you alive in this bedroom of yours. I want you to make sure that your wife is your star. I want you to do whatever it takes, as long as halal. If there are two things that we're not allowed to do, it's called mafhum al-mukhalafa. If we're not allowed to have intimate relations when your wife is in her menses, in that place, fil mahid, yeah? But you're allowed to do everything else between, yeah? Just leave that area and enjoy your wife, ya Sheikh. There's too many ways that you can look after each other. And the inner part, well, that's the two. Then if Allah said, and Prophet ﷺ said, these are not allowed, that means everything else is allowed. You understand? It's called mafhum al-mukhalafa. Don't tell me oral sex, with all due respect. And as I said, gloves are off. It's not allowed. It is allowed, yaqi. But some of the scholars will tell you, oh, if you do not want to use the same tongue that recites Quran in doing this, whatever. So I'm going to send the same analogy. If you're telling me that these eyes look at the Quran, you cannot use these eyes that look at the Quran, the same eyes that you want to look at your wife and when she's unclothed or nude. Come on, man. Give me a break. Wallahi, I'm telling you, it is extremely important for us to address these issues. Our marriages are breaking. Yes, extremely high numbers. If you think that this, I am just dealing with certain issues. Other mashayikh dealing with so many issues. So if we don't address it in the bedroom, if you don't look after each other, as I said, my approach is gloves off, man. It doesn't bother me anymore. When I used to go to the UK, these people are very posh, like, you know. Oh, don't say this, don't say sex. You have to say sexual intercourse. Yep. Does it make it halal haram? Let's talk about the issues. Don't look at the little bit of things. It is not what we're after. We're after fixing things. We're after saving marriages. We're after saving brothers and sisters. We're after saving generations from coming. So prevention is better than cure. Don't start anything you can't finish. And I want you to start when you open this website. Are you going to say Bismillah to open the website? After you finish watching the website, oh, Alhamdulillah. So if you can say, what do you drink? Drink alcohol. You go, Bismillah. Alhamdulillah. Or you smoke. Alhamdulillah. Do you do that? No. If you can't say Bismillah before you open, and you can't say Alhamdulillah after you finish, don't do it, man. So as I said, your bedroom is your castle. Ukhti, whatever it takes, my brother, look after each other. Communicate. Tell me what you like. Tell me what you don't like. How fast? How slow? This is what I role play. This is my fantasy. Whatever it takes, man, as I said, whatever it takes in the bedroom to look after one another, that's exactly what it is. As long as it's halal, don't shy away. Enjoy yourself, come up, introduce certain things, or try something new, whatever it takes, as I said, again, is my motto, and that's exactly what I'm going to leave you. I ask Allah subhanahu wa jalla bi'ala to make your home a home sweet home and to revive that sexual intercourse between the two of you in the halal means, so we'll not have the haram meal. So if we're going to make halal easy, haram will be difficult, not the other way around. With this, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all from these addictions, make our spouses the apple of our eyes, and make our children to be the leaders muttaqeen. Ameen. Wa afdawan. Alhamdulillahi rabbil ameen. Wa sallam ala alihi wa sahbihi wa tabi'een. جزاكم الله عنا خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.